Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh and hello everyone. In this video, we're going to learn topic number 5, states of matter, specifically 5.1 gas, covering for kinetic molecular theory, gas law and also ideal gas equations. Let's recall the definitions gas as a phase of matter where atoms of a substance are in motion and fills the container. We need a theory to explain the behavior of gases and the theory is called kinetic molecular theory. So this kinetic energy is a type of energy that anything has if it's moving. So this theory consists of 5 postulates, and from all these postulates, all of the ideal gas law can be derived. So the first assumptions made on ideal gas is based on the motions of gas particles. They are particles, either atoms or small molecules, since they are so tiny in size. They tend to move continuously and collide with both one another and the wall of container, which will then cause that random motions. But real gas actually do not move in such way, which we're going to make more sense of it by looking at postulate number 2. So the second postulate, we assume the gas particles are dimensionless. In other words, volume can be ignored. But in reality, molecules do occupy a measurable volume even if it's very small. We also assume gas particles do not interact with each other, hence forming only elastic collisions. This is not true in real gas. If the particles collide, they're still going to have electrostatic interactions, even just for a while. In relation to the third postulate, where it says ideal gas has only elastic collisions, next assumptions will be intermolecular forces is negligible. All molecules are attracted to one another by a combination of force. So these forces become particularly important for gases at low temperature and high pressure, where intermolecular distance are shorter. This is what happened in real gas. We cannot ignore the intermolecular forces. And lastly, at any time, some of the gas particles are moving faster than others, but the system can be described by average kinetic energy. When we increase the temperature of the system, we find that average kinetic energy of the gas particles increases as well. But this did not happen in real gas. The average kinetic energy is not always directly proportional to the absolute temperature, which is Kelvin. So this kinetic molecular theory can be used to explain each of the experimentally determined gas law we're going to look after this. When describing the physical behavior of gas, we want to be able to discuss the 4 variables. One is pressure. This is the force the gas is exerting on its container. So you should really be asking, how often will the gas particles hit the wall of container? Number 2, we have volume. So this volume tells us how big is the container should be. So these first 2 variables rely on one another. If the pressure is increased, the volume will decrease, or vice versa. Number 3, amount of substance, where we usually rely on the number of mole denoted by symbol N. So this number of mole tells you the number of gas particles present. And lastly, the temperature, the amount of heat energy available to be transferred into kinetic energy of motions, so how fast the particles will move. So all these variables depends on one another and have been formulated into laws. So we're going to look at the ideal gas law by looking first at the real gas law. Real gas involves 3 laws, and the first one is called Bohr's law. So Bohr's law states, at constant amount of gas and temperature, the pressure of gas is inversely proportional to the volume of gas, or vice versa. Imagine a piston. An amount of particles are moving at the same speed. Let's say we compress the volume of gas by half of it. We could see here from 4 liter to become 2 liter. This will cause its pressure to increase to double of its original value. So how do we know this? This can be seen when the particles collide with the wall of container more often. So because there is limited space to travel. So if we look at the number given here, we have 2 to become 4, means we double the value of the pressure. So this relationship can be illustrated on a graph, where we are going to have this graph written as pressure against 1 over volume, or volume against 1 over pressure. Both can be done on this diagram. So the volume changes with the change of pressure, but the product PV become constant. So hence, the Bohr's law equations is expressed as P1V1 equal to P2V2. Let's check comprehensions on Boyle's law. So we have a cylinder contains a gas at 5.25 atm pressure. When the gas allowed to expand to a final volume of 12.5 liter, the pressure dropped to 1.85 atm. So what was the original volume of the gas? So this question asks for the original volume, in other words, the V1. By applying Boyle's law, P1 V1 equal to P2 V2, where amount of gas and also the temperature is kept constant, we have P1, 5.25 atm, followed by final volume V2, 12.5 liter, and the final pressure of P2, 1.85 atm. So by rearranging the formula to find V1, we're going to multiply P2 V2 and divide them by P1. And then substitutes all the value, we're going to get V1 of 4.40 liter. Then let's try to relate value obtained from the given problem to the kinetic molecular theory of gas. Look at the variables given here. We have both pressure and also volume. Since we are keen for what have caused the collisions to be initiated, we'll first define gas pressure. So we're going to define gas pressure as a number of collisions between gas particles and the walls of container. Then for the next point, we can try to draw the consequences on the other variables, which is the volume. So how will this affect the number of collisions? So volume obtained from the questions is 4.40 liter, showed smaller number than the other one is 12.5 liter, with lower pressure of 1.85 atm. So this tells us that smaller volume cause the particles to collide more frequently as they have limited space to move around. And as for conclusions, we're going to take into account both pressure and also volume. We would say decreasing the volume of gas will result in increased pressure. The second gas law is called Charles' law. Charles' law describes the expansion. This expansion is referring to the volume of fixed amount of gas when they are heated at constant pressure. In other words, we're going to have a directly proportional relationship between the volume and also the temperature. We're going to look at this container. They contain a fixed amount of gas particles and then they are going to be heated at certain temperature. So the molecules in the gas exhibit increased movement. As you can see in here, the molecules begin to hit the walls of container more frequently, and that too increase the amount of force. If the wall of container is flexible, say a balloon, the pressure will remain constant, thereby allowing the volume to increase. So we could see from the relationship we apply in here, we have increase in temperature means the volume should increase as well. However, if the container is inflexible, they do not have the ability to expand themselves, the more frequent collisions happening in here just now will result in increased pressure. So this often be seen from the instructions on a bottle of deodorant. There's a warning sign indicating the bottle to be kept away from the sunlight and high temperature. Because if the bottle is left under high temperature, the air molecules inside the bottle will expand, which can lead to the bursting of the deodorant bottle. Since the volume of the gas is proportional to the temperature of the system, we could see from this graph, hence the Charles' law equations is expressed as V1 over T1 equal to V2 over T2. Let's try to solve Charles' law problem. An engineer pumps air at 0 degrees Celsius into a newly designed piston cylinder assembly. The volume measures 6.83 cm cubic. At what temperature in Kelvin will the volume be 9.75 cm cubic? So you are given both volume and also temperature. We need to rely on the Charles' law expressions V1 over T1 equal to V2 over T2, where the mole and also the pressure is kept constant. Anything mentioned first is going to be the first value, while the latter one is going to be the second value. So we are going to find the T2, the final temperature. We have T1 equal to 273.15 Kelvin. We have V1 equal to 6.83 cm cubic. And then we have V2 equal to 9.75 cm cubic. We want to find the T2 in here. So T2 now should be in Kelvin as well as the T1 because it mentioned here in Kelvin. Even if the question isn't asked for Kelvin, you need to know the temperature here belongs to absolute temperature. Absolute temperature should consider Kelvin. And then we're going to rearrange the formula to become V2 times T1 divided by V1. And we're going to get 390K as our final temperature. To explain what happens according to Charles' law in kinetic molecular setting, we'll first define temperature as a measure of kinetic energy of the gas particles. So then, what will happen to the other variables, which is the volume? If we increase the temperature as suggested in the answer, 390K, which is greater than 273.15 Kelvin, the number of collisions will also increase as particles move faster at higher temperature. And they will use up more space to move around to avoid the collisions with the wall of container, indicates bigger volume. So as for conclusions, we would say increasing the temperature will result in increased volume. The third gas law is called Avogadro's law. Avogadro's law states at constant temperature and pressure, the volume of gas is directly proportional to the number of moles of the gas present. Flexible containers such as balloons will expand until the pressure of the gas inside the balloon once again balances with the pressure outside the balloon. As the number of gas particles increases, the frequency of collisions with the walls of the container must also increase. This in turn leads to an increase in the pressure of the gas. So we could say that the volume will increase as well as the number of particles increase. Therefore, they're going to have a directly proportional relationship between one another. Hence, the Avogadro's law equations is expressed as V1 over N1 equal to V2 over N2. Let's try to solve problems involving Avogadro's law. Nitrogen monoxide combines with oxygen to form nitrogen dioxide. You are given these chemical equations, check if they are balanced or not. If 1 liter oxygen gas at 30.25 degrees Celsius and 0.975 atm is used, and there is an excess of NO, what volume in liter of the NO gas will be at the same temperature and pressure if they converted to NO2? Okay, we already have this information, same temperature and also pressure, means we're going to use the Avogadro's law, V1 over N1 equal to V2 over N2. So not all problems involving gas law require calculations. Since we already have the balance equations in here, 2NO plus O2 to form 2NO2, rewrite the equations and take out the informations as in the number of moles given in here. If volume is directly proportional to the number of moles, say we have 1 liter of O2, means the mole gonna be 1 mole as well. As for both nitrogen oxide and also nitrogen dioxide, they both got 2 mole, means the volume gonna be 2 liter. So the volume of NO gas at the same temperature and pressure will be 2 liter. As for explanations regarding kinetic molecular theory, we're gonna have more particles in the sample, means more volume of gas to comply with the conditions of both pressure and also temperature to keep constant. And then in short, increasing the amount of gas will result in increase in volume. To summarize, you are going to use one of these gas law when you are given some initial or final conditions. Just substitute the value that you know and solve for what you don't. Although no ideal gas actually exists, most simple gas such as N2, O2, H2 and noble gas show nearly ideal behavior at ordinary temperature and pressure. By combining both Boyle's and Charles' law, we're going to form combined gas law of PV over T. Avogadro's law says equal number of volumes of gas at the same temperature and pressure contains the same number of molecules. So this is referring to specifically the 1 mole of ideal gas occupies 22.4 liter at standard temperature and pressure. Lastly, all the variables correlate in one equations, forming ideal gas equations PV equal to nRT. So these equations contain constants of R with specific value with respect to certain units. So you could see we have different units in here. You are free to choose which of those to be used, but make sure the units in here tally with the variables given in your questions. This equation is useful to find the value of one of the four variables here that went missing. The most common applications of the ideal gas law is calculations of molar mass. But before we further substitute the symbol, we first rearrange them into PV equal to nRT to become N over V equal to P over RT. So this N over V indicates concentrations. Okay, you can also find the concentrations from PV equal to nRT, simply rearrange them. To get molar mass, we need to first substitute this N with mass over molar mass. Once we substitute this mass over molar mass into PV equal to nRT, we'll have mass over molar mass times volume equal to PRT. So from here, we're going to rearrange them to become mRT over PV, or you can also rearrange them in terms of density by first group the m over v. This m over v belongs to mass over volume, which indicates the density. And lastly, we're going to get drt over p if we are referring to the density given, because sometimes the questions can give you density. Let's check comprehensions on ideal gas equations. Given 1.27 gram sample of an oxide of nitrogen, believed to be either NO or N2O, occupies a volume of 1.07 liter and 25 degrees Celsius and 737 mmHg. What oxide is it? So the question wants you to find what kind of sample is this, either NO or N2O. To know this, since the compound got both nitrogen and oxygen, we're going to look for its molecular mass. So let's first extract the information given. We have mass of 1.27 gram, followed by volume 1.07 liter. The temperature here is 25 degrees C, but since we are dealing with gas particles, we need to first convert it to Kelvin by adding 273.15, giving 298.15 Kelvin. And lastly, the pressure is 737 mmHg. Since the questions provide volume in liter, we need to look at the constants that got in 8 liter in order to use R equal to 0.08206 at the m liter per mole per k. We are going to change this mmHg to become atm by multiplying with everyone atm equal to 760 mmHg. By cancelling the unit, you will be left with 0.970 atm as the pressure for these reactions. Assuming the settings now all obey 5 kinetic molecular gas, where volume of gas is negligible, intermolecular forces also negligible, elastic collisions takes place, gas particles moves in random and continuous motions, and average kinetic energy directly proportional to absolute temperature, we're going to use ideal gas equations of PV equal to nRT. Note that we can further derive these equations to suit the needs conveyed by the problem, which asks for molecular mass. So from these equations, we can substitute this N with number of mole over molar mass, mass over molar mass. So we're going to rearrange these equations to become molar mass equal to mRT over PV. Simply substitute all the informations we have gathered just now. So this is our mass, this is our R. Note that we have liter in here. And then we have a temperature in Kelvin divided by our pressure again in atm. So we have both atm in here. Volume is 1.07 liter. So we can discard the same unit present if their relationship is inverse. Like here we have atm and then we have liter ups and down here. And then as for Kelvin, we have both up here, but they have inverse relationship. Then we can cancel them out, leaving us with only gram and mole. So this gram and mole will tell you about the molar mass, 29.9 gram per mole. Then we are going to check whether this 29.9 tally with nitrogen oxide or nitrogen dioxide. So it is believed to be oxide belongs to nitrogen oxide NO. That's all for the first part of 5.1 gas, covering kinetic molecular theory, real gas law, and also ideal gas law. Stay tuned for the next part. Thank you.